Health and safety is on all our minds, but you should also be concerned with your finances too. I'm here to clear up any misinformation about what to do during these stressful times. You may have heard that the federal government has slashed interest rates to near zero. That's intended to keep the economy from crashing. But it also means some lenders are now advertising mortgage refinancing and home equity lines of credit. I'm urging you to be cautious of these offers. There are many ways to stretch your dollars, and there are options for loans that don't jeopardize your home that can be a better fit for you. This is not the time to make sudden and drastic decisions that will haunt you well after the emergency passes. Don't take your money out of your retirement accounts. Don't sell all of your stocks and investments. Don't panic buy supplies in massive quantities and put them on your credit cards. And above all, stay calm. This is not the first time we have seen the market go down like this. Do you remember the crash of 87? What about the dot-com bubble bursting in 2000? Even 9/11, the stock market crashed. And what about the massive drop during the Great Recession? If you're working out of your home and in a self-quarantine situation, then now is the time to go over all of your finances and evaluate. Do you have the right insurances at the best prices? What about your credit card interest rates? How much debt are you carrying? If you don't have a budget, now is the time to build it. Find out how much money you can put towards paying off your debts or put into a savings account. My advice to you is if you're not sure, do nothing. Most of all, don't panic. Debt.com is here to help Americans receive financial counseling. And I'm asking you, if you don't call us for a free debt analysis, call somebody reputable and knowledgeable. If your health suffers, you consult a medical expert. If your finances suffer, you call Debt.com. Thank you and be safe.